Hi everyone, it's Raf from Advanced Performance Solutions. In today's video we will discuss about the application of microdosing of strength training in sports and more specifically in football. So, what do we really mean when we say microdosing of strength training? Although this term has not been defined yet, microdosing refers to the division of traditional strength training in very small doses, performed frequently with the aim to maintain the benefits associated with traditional strength training and, at the same time, minimize the undesirable side effects. And I will explain what I mean by that shortly. So now that we have established what we mean by microdosing, let's take a look at how football clubs can benefit from microdosing during a busy competitive season. But before we go into that, we first need to take a look at how traditional strength training fits into weekly training plans, and the limitations associated with its use. For the majority of competitive season, teams usually play 1 to 2 games per week. So let's just start by looking at the most typical scenario, which involves 1 game per week. A common approach is to perform strength training only once a week. In addition, the current models suggest to perform strength training approximately in the middle of the week. This is done so athletes have enough time to recover from the previous game and to ensure that the fatiguing effects associated with strength training will be fully diminished by the day of competition. And, although this approach may be effective for a lot of athletes, in some cases the fatiguing effects of strength training, especially when condensing all training volume into one session, may have a negative impact on the quality of the subsequent training sessions, by minimizing the room for athletic development and at the same time increasing injury risk. Of course, you can argue that you can do a low volume, low intensity session to avoid inducing fatigue. However, then you need to ask yourself, is a low volume, low intensity session, performed once a week, enough to develop or even maintain strength-related adaptations to my athletes? So, let's now move on to the most demanding scenario, which involves 2 games per week. As you can see, there is no room for any traditional strength training. And this is expected since there is not enough time to recover from the game, do a strength training session, and fully recover from it until the next game. Therefore, the current models suggest to omit strength training during periods with 2 games per week and reintroduce it when the competition schedule returns back to 1 game per week. And although this makes a lot of sense, we also need to consider that a lot of teams have 2 games per week scheduled for several weeks in a row. Therefore, if strength training is omitted for an extended period of time, it may lead in losing some strength-related adaptations which can impact both performance and injury risk. So now that we have established the limitations that are associated with traditional strength training, let's take a look at the potential benefits of microdosing and how it can address some of the limitations associated with the application of traditional strength training. To start with, microdosing is a lot more time efficient. And this is particularly important since during busy periods in the season, time availability is a big issue for a lot of clubs, especially when there is a high requirement for traveling. The traditional strength training method requires to dedicate a whole 40 to 60 minute session, whereas with microdosing you can get away by just doing an additional 10 to 15 minutes of training on daily basis, which can even be done as part of the warm-up. Therefore, you do not need an additional session for strength training. Moving on, microdosing allows for more opportunities to train when athletes feel fresh. The fact that you get the opportunity to train on daily basis allows for adjustments on training dose based on athletes' readiness to training, whereas with the traditional approach in which the strength training day is fixed, you may lose the opportunity to train your athletes when they feel good. Therefore, as you can see, the planning and scheduling of strength training is more flexible using the microdosing approach. In addition, microdosing may accumulate less fatigue. By splitting up the volume, it is less likely to induce muscle soreness or fatigue in comparison to condensing all the volume in one session. Therefore, you will still end up with similar gains in strength, since frequency does not appear to influence strength, but with less fatigue and soreness. Furthermore, small doses of high-intensity activity have been shown to acutely enhance power and strength-related performance through the mechanism of post-activation performance enhancement. Therefore, we can get our athletes in a potentiated state by using micro-dosing prior to training. In addition, small doses of resistance training are associated with delayed potentiation effects 6 to 24 hours prior to competition. Therefore, appropriate application of microdosing the day before or the day of competition can result in enhanced neuromuscular performance. Finally, the higher frequency, which is a characteristic of the micro-dosing approach, appears to be more beneficial for motor learning, which is particularly important when training youth athletes. All in all, appropriate application of micro-dosing allows to train even during the busiest periods in the season without the fear of inducing fatigue or soreness, and it can also act as a tool to best prepare athletes for training or competition. Thank you for watching. More information on micro-dosing coming soon.